Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we will discuss how to graph rational functions, identifying zeros and asymptotes when suitable factorizations are available, and showing end behavior. First of all, let us see what is a rational function. Now, a rational function is a function that can be written as f of x upon g of x, where g of x is not equal to 0, and where f of x and g of x are polynomials. Now, let us discuss steps to graph a rational function of the form y is equal to f of x upon g of x. In the first step, find the vertical asymptotes by finding zeros of denominator g of x. Now, these zeros will be vertical asymptotes if they are not the zeros of numerator f of x. In the next step, we find the horizontal asymptote by using the following facts. Now, if degree of f of x is less than degree of g of x, then there is a horizontal asymptote at y is equal to 0. And if degree of f of x is greater than degree of g of x, then there is no horizontal asymptote. If degree of f of x is equal to degree of g of x, then there is a horizontal asymptote at y is equal to a upon b, where a is the leading coefficient of f of x and b is the leading coefficient of g of x. Now, after finding the vertical asymptote, then horizontal asymptote, in the next step, we find x-intercepts by finding zeros of f of x. These zeros will be the x-intercepts if they are not the zeros of g of x. Then, in the next step, find y-intercept by putting x is equal to 0 in the given function. Now, the vertical asymptotes will divide the number line into regions. Graph at least one point in each region. This point will tell us whether the graph will be above or below the horizontal asymptote. And if we need, we can plot several points to determine the general shape of the graph. And then, in the next step, we will sketch the graph. Also, you must note that if there is a common zero of f of x and g of x, this represents a hole in the graph. Then simplify the given fraction and put the x value, that is the common zero. The obtained point is the point where hole exists in the graph. And vertical asymptotes cannot be crossed because they describe where the graph is undefined. Horizontal asymptotes may be crossed as they describe only what happens to the graph as x gets very large or very small. Now let us discuss an example. Here we have to draw the graph of the function y is equal to 2x plus 4 whole upon x plus 1, which is of the form y is equal to f of x upon g of x. So in first step, we will find vertical asymptote by finding zeros of the denominator f of c minus h is less than f of c, and f of c plus h is less than f of c when the function is maximum at x is equal to c. So, x is equal to minus 1 is the vertical asymptote. Then in the second step, we will find horizontal asymptote. For this, we will make use of these facts which we have discussed earlier. Now, here we have this function And here, f of x is equal to 2x plus 4 and g of x is equal to x plus 1. Now here, degree of f of x is 1 and degree of g of x is again 1. So we will use this fact to find the horizontal asymptote, as degree of f of x is equal to degree of g of x. So here the horizontal asymptote will be at y is equal to a upon b, where a is leading coefficient of f of x and b is leading coefficient of g of x. Now here leading coefficient of f of x is 2 and leading coefficient of g of x will be coefficient of x, that is 1. So horizontal asymptote will be at y is equal to a upon b, that is equal to 2 upon 1, which implies y is equal to 2. Now in the next step we will find the x-intercepts by finding zeros of f of x. For this, we will put numerator is equal to 0. So we have 2x plus 4 is equal to 0, which implies x is equal to minus 2. So x-intercept is given by the ordered pair minus 2, 0. Now in the next step, we find the y-intercept. For this, we put x is equal to 0 in the given function. And we get y is equal to 2 into 0 plus 4 whole upon 0 plus 1, which implies y is equal to 4. So y-intercept is given by the ordered pair 0, 4. Now on this coordinate plane, let us draw the vertical asymptote, that is given by x is equal to minus 1. So we have drawn this vertical asymptote. Now this vertical asymptote divides this graph in two regions. One is x is less than minus 1 and the second region is x is greater than minus 1. Now we will draw the horizontal asymptote also, which is given by the line y is equal to 2. So this is the horizontal asymptote. Now we have already got the x-intercept and the y-intercept. Now let us plot these two points on the graph. This is the point minus 2, 0, and this is the point 0, 4. Now the x-intercept lies in the lower left region and the y-intercept lies in the upper right region. Let us find some more points in these two regions so that we can clearly determine its behavior. Now, putting x is equal to minus 3 in this function, we get y is equal to 1. Similarly, for x is equal to minus 4, we get y is equal to 1.3. For x is equal to minus 0.5, we get y is equal to 6. Then for x is equal to 1, we get y is equal to 3, and for x is equal to 4, we get y is equal to 2.4. Now let us plot all these points on the graph. So we have plotted all these points on the graph. Now joining all these points, we get this graph. Now in this graph, you can see in the lower left region, as x tends to minus 1, y tends to minus infinity, and on this side, as x tends to minus infinity, y tends to 2, and in the upper right region, we can see that as x tends to infinity, y tends to 2, and on this side, as x tends to minus 1, y tends to infinity, So this is the end behavior of the function y is equal to 2x plus 4 all upon x plus 1. And in this fashion we have learned how to graph rational functions, identifying zeros and asymptotes when suitable factorizations are available. So this completes the session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.